Hi, I'm creating a video about creating a subset data. So for this, I'm going to use a dataset that is a built-in dataset. It is called empty cars. So first of all, I'm using the data function to get access to the data. And then I am curious about what variables I have in the data, so I type the names function of the dataset name so that I can see what variables are there. So you can see MPG, CYL, this might be cylinder, right? And we also have other variables which we may not be familiar with, like from their name, we may not know what variables are they. So the second thing I'm doing here is to use a question mark of the data set. And in that way, I'm going to get a detailed explanation on the right corner here. So this is a data set about motor trend car road tests. And you can see this data set is from 1974. And this is a data set with 32 observations on 11 numeric variables. And they even have a description on which variable, like all the variable names, what are they, and what are the, for here, like for example, what is the unit of that weight variable, and what does 1 mean, what does 0 mean if it is a dummy variable, so 0, 1 binary variable. So in that way, we have a better idea about what the data set is about and what variables are available to us. So you can also run you can also view the data here, the whole data here, because the data set is not very large. You can see we only have 32 observations on 11 variables. So I'm going to view the data and you're going to see what variables are available and what are the data range for each variable. So you can see that. And then, because my topic here is to create a subset data set, so I'm going to create a subset using a function called subset. Yes, the function name is right directing what we are doing. So I'm going to, for example, looking at the MPG value, right? You can even run a summary of it. You cannot run the summary function on a variable itself. So you need to copy the dataset name and use the dollar sign so that we are directing the variable MPG from the dataset named as empty cars. So if you run a summary function, we are getting the summaries of this numerical variable. So we have minimum value, first quantile, median, mean, and so on. So suppose my goal here is to create a subset based on MPG, create a subset dataset based on MPG greater than, for example, I want to create a dataset where all the MPGs are greater than 20. So I'm going to do that using subset function. I'm going to type the function, the dataset name there, and then I'm going to assign MPG greater than 20. So let's try to run it and see. So you can see once I run it, I get the dataset right printed in the console. Let's save that dataset because we don't want it printed in the console, because sometimes when you create a subset, you may want to do analysis on that data. So we can actually save the data as, I'm not going to save it as empty cars because it is very important to keep a copy of the original dataset. So I'm going to call it empty cars, underline, MPG20. Let's call it MPG20. So that you know you are describing the data, you are creating a data set based on MPG values and using a standard of 20. So in that way, I write and it's all blue in the console, which means there is no error or warning. And you can even check the data. You can even check the summary of this data set $ of MPG so that you can see is your minimum value still greater than 20. Yes, the minimum value here is 21. So that means you may have created a subset correctly. So let's talk about a second way to create a data set. MPG greater than 20 using a function called filter. And that filter function is actually from a package called dplyr. So I'm not going to install the package here, but if you haven't installed it, you need to install that package before you use it. So you need to run install.packages double quotation mark with dplyr in it. And once you package dplyr, you actually need to use the function called library. So it is like, I'm going to load the package so that I can use the function filter, which is a function from this package here. So you need to run the library function so that you can use the, there is some warning message there, but it's fine. So I'm going to use the function filter, but before that, I'm going to introduce a name called pipe, which is written out as this sign. So if you're using a Mac, you just type Shift, Command, and M, all three keys together, and you're getting this notation. And first thing I'm going to do is I copy and paste the dataset name, and then I use a pipe, and then I use filter function on it. So within the filter function, I can type any conditions I would like. So for example, I want to use MPG greater than 20. So I just type that function in, and in that way, I'm actually filtering the dataset. So you can see MPG is actually starting from 21 here. And again, we don't want the data printed in the console. We want to save it so we can do further analysis on it. So one way to do it is to use this sign and then name it mtcars. I'm not going to use the same name mg20 here. Maybe I can call it 20mpg. So if you run that, the data is actually saved in this name and you can do further analysis on it. So again, I'm going to check if I have filtered my data correctly. So 20mpg, and then I'm going to check the mpg variable. So the minimum is 21. So these are the two ways to create a subset dataset. You can either use subset function or you can use a filter function from dplyr package. And that's it.